Only 4 countries in the world are currently recognized to have the nuclear triad, namely the United States, Russia, China, and India. The nuclear triad is the ability to launch nukes from land by land-based missiles, from the air through long-range strategic bombers, and from the sea through submarine-launched ballistic missiles. The last leg of the triad, that's the ability to launch nukes from sea, is the most survival part of the triad, since submarine-launched ballistic missiles, SLBM, are least vulnerable to preemptive strikes, as submarines can roam under the sea without getting detected by the prying eyes of enemy satellites and reconnaissance aircrafts. SLBMs make sure that the country will have a credible second strike capability. That is, even if it's attacked first by nukes, it will have a way to retaliate back. This is the reason that SLBMs are considered to be the most potent form of nuclear deterrence. The JL-2, also known as the Zhulang-2 or Giant Wave-2, is a Chinese intercontinental range submarine-launched ballistic missile. It's believed to have been developed jointly with the DF-31 land-based ICBM beginning in 1970. The missile's been designed as an improvement over the JL-1 and has now completely replaced the former. Trident-2 is a missile designed by Lockheed Martin Space Systems in California, United States. It's deployed by the American and British navies. Trident-2 was designed to be more advanced than Trident-1, which was retired in 2005. It has greater range and payload capacity than the former. In this video, Defense Updates compares the two SLBMs, Chinese JL-2 and United States Trident-2, and draws an unbiased conclusion. Let's get started.
Number 5.
JL-2 is a 3-stage solid propellant ballistic missile. The Trident-2 is also a 3-stage rocket, each stage containing a solid fuel rocket motor. Solid fuel missiles can stand ready for extended periods of time with little maintenance and was the choice for both the countries. This category is a tie.
Number 4.
As of 2016, China deploys 4 Jin-class nuclear ballistic missile submarines, each armed with 12 JL-2 ICBMs. Chinese plans call for the production of a total of 12 Jin-class submarines. 14 ballistic missile submarines of Ohio class together carry approximately 50% of the total U.S. active inventory of strategic thermonuclear warheads, with each of the submarines carrying 24 Trident-2 missiles. Distinct advantage goes to Trident-2 as it's better accommodated in its launch platform.
Number 3.
The JL-2 missile uses an inertial guidance system and a global positioning satellite GPS system. It may also employ the BiDown navigational satellite system. This missile will likely have an accuracy of 150 or 300 meters CEP. The Trident-2 missile uses Mark 6 astro-inertial guidance, which is able to receive GPS, global positioning system, updates. The missile has an accuracy of 90 meters, making it one of the most accurate long-range strategic missiles in the world. Advantage goes to Trident-2 in this category.
Number 2.
The JL-2 has a minimum range of 2,000 kilometers and a maximum range of greater than 8,000 kilometers. The Trident-2 has a range of more than 7,500 miles or 12,000 kilometers. This range enables the missile to be launched from far off from the target. Significantly better range gives advantage to Trident-2.
Number 1.
JL-2 weighs in at 42,000 kilograms, whereas Trident-2 weighs in at 59,000 kilograms. The larger size and more advanced technology enables Trident-2 to carry more warheads. JL-2 missiles are believed to be armed with a single 1 megaton yield nuclear warhead, but is also capable of delivering 3-8 90 kiloton MIRV, that's multiple independent reentry vehicle, warheads. Trident-2 can be configured with 2 types of MIRV. The Mark 5 MIRV can carry up to 14 W88 475 kiloton warheads, while the Mark 4 MIRV having the ability to carry 14 W76 100 kiloton warheads. Trident 2 has more overall better payload capacity and has more MIRV warheads, giving it a solid advantage. The United States Department of Defense believes JL-2 will give the People's Liberation Army Navy its first credible sea-based nuclear deterrent. The missile demonstrates the increasing technological advancement of the Chinese forces. As representative in the final score, the Trident 2 is overall a better missile. The technological prowess of the Trident 2 can be gauged from the fact that even next generation of US and UK submarines will field them. The Ohio's class submarines are forecast to move out of service between 2027 and 2040, but the incoming Columbia class, the first vessel of which is scheduled to enter service in 2031, will continue to deploy the Trident 2. And a common missile compartment designed to house the missiles will be a feature of both the Columbia design and the incoming British Dreadnought class submarines, which will begin to replace the current UK Vanguard class from 2028. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.